So we're going to talk basic stuff here, so we're not going to go deep.
Preach the gospel and make disciples. Take the prison of peace to your living room. This is an everyday life.
So we need to make this reality and a normal life.
How's the pain?
It's gone. It's gone.
No
it's
pain. Old,
no, it's gone.
That's okay. Amazing. Okay. Jesus.
Yeah.
Just carrying the prayers through, and but this guy
the last part of the break, and it just sort of reminds me so much of me, not that I'm good at it anymore, but it just reminds me of me before I was safe. I just know I can see that. And Paul posted about this, his weaknesses, you know, he testified about how rotten he was. That's what he posted about. So I can identify with that because I was really rotten before I accepted Christ. But we were praying for him, and I just know that I know that there was a spirit of murder on his life, like homicide, the spirit of homicide right over him. And we were praying, and it went up his back, and it sort of got stuck on his shoulders. And the guys just kept praying, and then it was on his head. And that's where we're on, you know, that's where the three men were there. We're all there, all four of us were there, but at that stage, it was good for the men to be just praying for this man. That spirit was looking for excuses, man.
Yeah.
He tried to sit down, and he wants the demon told us he wants to go home and lie down. But you've got to persevere. And then it got off his head. And because he was telling us, I can't think straight. And once it got off his head, that's when we could really minister to the person. You know? And he got set free, you know?
Yeah.
Really. And trust, you know, trust. They were having a party, and they turned the music off, they put the drinks away, and they came to the light.
And he wants to get baptized?
Yeah. And he's just a man like us. He's just a person. He's not a murderer. He's not a murderer. He's not seeing like that.
I went inside with the lady, and then she started just opening up about some struggles that she's had. And I asked her if she's been baptized with her spirit. She said, no, not yet. She doesn't have a language. And so then I called the guys in, and we started to pray for her. And she received the language, which is awesome. It's not, she didn't receive many words, she received maybe two words, but she was bubbling over, so it was awesome. And then the Holy Spirit also just touched her, and she needed to forgive someone, and she was able to forgive them. It was just amazing. We could have gone home after that. And then we moved up, and while the guys were also praying for this one guy with the hectic stuff with the moon, and there were a few girls that came out. So I was just kind of standing to the side, and so they were standing there, and I said, well, do you need something? And so it was a mom that brought a girl out, and she said that her girl has been suffering with pain, with appendix pain. And they had been wanting to take her to the hospital, but they weren't able to. And so I said, well, let's pray. And so I prayed for it, and I said, well, test it. And so she's standing there, and she's like pressing, and she's pressing again, she's pressing again, and she says, it's gone. And so, the swelling went, the pain went, and she was fine. She went in inside, and then some of the other ladies came out, she said, no, she's fine, she's fine. They put stuff on there to kind of try to ease the pain. She took it off. She's fine. And then another lady came. She asked for prayer. And then another lady came and she asked for prayer. And so the third lady, she was actually at the moment she was backsliding, and she just really needed to know that Jesus sees her, that he hasn't forgotten about her, he hasn't left her for saving her. And there was, she said there was a prophet that had spoken and finished her. And so it was just awesome to break those words over her and just to declare freedom and say these things don't die in life. And then just trust with her for she wants, she really wants a future husband. So sometimes the things that people trust for seem small, but it's huge. So it was an awesome time.
Yaffi and I went to Rosemore, and it was actually hard to put it into words in a minute or two, and because obviously there was a lot of things that stood out. You know, in the whole time that we've been speaking this weekend, is the scripture that keeps on coming back into my mind is taste and see that the Lord is good. And the first house that we went into, this lady's house, she actually invited us in. So I was quite surprised that she invited us in. And as she invited us in, there were cakes and treats on the table. And that struck me immediately, because I was again reminded of the scripture, taste and see that the Lord is good. We obviously asked them, this particular lady, the name was Johanna. She said she had a sore throat, we prayed for her throat. And she also said that she's got diabetes. And we also prayed for her diabetes. And I just saw this picture of, when you normally put sugar into a glass of water, the sugar falls right down to the bottom. When you take a sip of the water, you don't really taste it, it's sweet. You first have to stir it, and once you stir it, you take another sip, and it's sweet. And I really, we prayed for her, I really trust her. When she goes back in 6 months' time, she will have to come with us. And she'll be used from my lead, just because God stirred her. The other lady, she had also a pain in her leg, a pain in her back, a falcon in the heart of her feet. And we prayed for her as well. One thing that stood out is just Yaakov's perseverance in praying, for the deck to extend. And it took a while, but eventually, it's both legs were on the same length. There was another gentleman that had a tough time walking. He's got arthritis in his knees. And as I prayed for him, I could really just feel his knee going like this, shaking, as they say. And afterwards, he said all his pain was gone. And he had much more ease of movement, and he could actually pick up his leg as opposed to just walk like this. But the other thing is, while we were busy praying for him, there was a guy standing in his house watching us. And he also invited us in and said, he's from prayer. He's got problems not remembering. He's losing his memory a bit. And he prayed for him. And so the thing that actually stood out is how keen people are to actually have you pray for them, and that they invite you into their homes. And even one of the younger girls, we passed it by two young girls, and we're just disciples of Jesus. We pray for people, they've got any pains or anything we could pray for. And you can see that teenage girls, they're quite cheeky, so they're like, no, that's daddy. And they asked us where we're from. We just had a quick chat, and the one good young girl said, it's nice, you should do it some more. And it's sometimes those subtleties that kind of stick with you. That was our experience.
Awesome.
We just went into the tower, and it's a lady, and I prayed for her, and she said she had headache and she had backache, and I prayed for her, laid hands on her, and the pain be gone in Jesus' name, and it was gone. And it was just amazing. It wasn't something big, but I'm like, yo. I always thought that you pray for someone and then maybe one day they'll be better. It did take some time, and you have this theology thing in your head going. But now it's made it, it's really like, it's gone. Is it gone? It's gone. It's amazing, we prayed for another guy as well, and he was a Muslim guy, and he's also like, what is gone? But he can't really speak English, and I translated to the guy next to him. What? It's really gone, it's gone! He was so excited, and he invited him tomorrow, so we hope we'll see him here tomorrow in line. See you all. Yeah. So we hope we'll be here.
Yeah.
What happened? My name is Richard, who's the lady told her. So, you got all the healthy people. It's funny, but there was this one nice testimony of the lady that we prayed for her back. She had pain in her back and we all touched her. But you could immediately see she was at peace even before we prayed for her. And she testified with someone of you here. She said the group preached or prayed for her recently. I didn't take the name, so maybe it's, you don't know the name to keep you on board. But it was somebody who prayed for her recently for finances, for supply for finances, and she's a speaker in town. And I think it was the same day actually when they prayed for her. She's sweet and she came upon a long sucking, a bank bag with 1,200 rand in it, and that's what she needed apparently. So the Lord, and there was nobody else there, so she, that was a provision. So that was very nice to hear. The rest was headaches, but the Lord touched people and the back, lower back. It's the money thing, that still helps me. That's a wonderful testimony where the Lord came through to someone.
I went to go pray for two Muslim guys, street vendors, but I really like them. They really got nice characters once. They two friends and they go school next to each other. You asked, listen, is there something wrong with you? The guy said, no, the guy that we actually prayed for, he couldn't really speak English that well, so his friend, the funny guy, had to interpret. And anyway, so he asked, we prayed for his back, and he said that was healed. What? He was like, that's healed. And his friend started laughing, so he said, no, don't laugh. It's actually, I'm actually healed. You know, so he said, this is not a joke. And then he said, let's pray for his leg, we prayed for his leg. And he said, no, this thing is really real. This is like, this, I'm healed now. And then he spoke to him, was ministering to his friend as well. But what I saw was just an openness, that there's people out there that are just, they have hunger for truth, and they hope. People are hoping. The thing that was stood out for me is that it's the 1% that will just be good, but 99% are hungry and there is a need out there and they're open for someone to just pray for them. So
that's it. That's a lot. It's been a lovely place to be. Lots of English. We went out, in the last clip, while I was busy talking to him and about the guy, the young man walked past me and I caught his eye and then he walked away. We missed him actually. And then 20 minutes later, on our way home actually, we saw him and a friend coming from the front. But you know, when you're excited to see two of them, you know, it's stirring your heart. So I was very excited to see him because I noticed him while walking past us. And then we talked to him and we prayed for him. He really just asked him what's wrong, he said, yep, there's a lot of things wrong. So I was like, yeah, great. So it was just like his back and something else. And then we prayed for him. I could pray for him also. And when we finished praying, we kind of asked, how's your back? He's like, forget about my back. I just feel different. Like, you shoot yourself, like, completely different and change. And then he turned around. Pray for my friend, but then he was already busy because he kind of said she doesn't believe in the Lord. And then I quickly had to go home now. So we kind of chatted him and I told him about, I just had a word of wisdom for him. So I shared with him and you could see he was really touched by just the encounter with the Lord. And the girl was also really touched with the encounter with the Lord. And so I talked about the baptism tomorrow morning. I was wondering if going to come, and then on my way home, hit the Courtney Street road. Then the other two of them come to walking towards me, and then I just waved at them, and I couldn't believe I saw them again. And on my way back, I stopped at Checkers to grab something to eat. And while out of my body, here comes the same guy walking towards me, and I'm like, no way. And he walks past me, and then shoved me enough because I really felt like actually. I felt like I should have prayed for the Holy Spirit for you. And I know it's a different order, but I really felt if he
if there were floating the Holy Spirit, then it'll definitely come tomorrow for the baptism, because it'll just be that visible, you know, the Lord has touched me, because I can see what's really touched already. And then the shocking enough, he was the one who turned to me and told me, maybe there's a reason why this is the third time I'm walking into you. And then I told him, yes, and we just sat down a bunk outside of James and I prayed for the Holy Spirit again and get that back to full deliver for tomorrow. But I can just share, and then I asked him to ask the Lord for it, and then he asked the Lord for everything else and for you for something else that he didn't even mention to us. And he was just so open, he just confessed his heart towards the Lord, and then it was just, you could see he was so open. I told him, hopefully, or I told him tomorrow morning, I don't know, he said he'll be there with his friend. But anyway, it was just amazing. The Lord just orchestrated things. It's just like the third time in 3/4 of an hour that I've seen the same little man, or the same young man that, you know, really made me back.
So we just started walking from here, and we went down this path in here at the Nonarani Street. We got a couple of older people, prayed for them, and then we got to these four school guys. Busy drinking, yeah, the one drinker. And I actually saw that there's rats with them as well. So I started sharing, talking to them, starting off with asking them about if they had anything that has pain and everything. And they're all known, everybody has pain. And the one guy, at that point, we started actually praying for them. And the one guy, I actually felt that some of their legs are not aligned. And I actually tested two or three of them. Actually, the legs weren't aligned, and I prayed for them. I took the picture. And at a point I got the chess game ready, because I saw that these guys, they're not right with God yet, but they actually needed it. And the guy that was actually the scoring, the leader of the group, he has God's placed a leadership role in his life. He actually, from the beginning to there, actually turned off. See, there's a whole turn towards what I'm explaining. And the end of the four guys, that's the guy that actually decided he wants to repent and turn to God. So we took him apart, we prayed for him, he repented of a lot of stuff. And then we prayed for him for the baptism of the Holy Spirit as well. And he walked away lighter, with the other three just left with him.
He just said, cast out the demons. Read the word, and you do what the word says about the demonic. But those that's here, you learn a lot of stuff, you saw a lot of stuff.